Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. In the previous video, we have seen that what is Zener diode and how it can be used as a voltage regulator. And we have also seen the few examples based on this Zener regulator circuit. But in those examples, during the analysis, we have assumed that the Zener diode is ideal, meaning that in the breakdown region of operation, the Zener resistance is zero. And we have also assumed that the Zener knee current of the Zener diode is negligible, meaning that to turn on the Zener diode in the breakdown region, the required current is almost negligible. But actually, this Zener diode requires some finite amount of current, or in other words, we can say that this Zener knee current is non-zero. And during the breakdown region of operation, this Zener diode also have some finite Zener resistance. So considering this non-ideal Zener diode, let us solve some problems based on this Zener regulator circuit. So in the first example, we have been given this Zener regulator circuit, and in this circuit, the knee current of the Zener diode is 10 mA. And we have been asked to find the minimum value of this load such that the 5 volt of voltage is maintained across this load resistor. And apart from that, we have been also asked to find the minimum power rating of this Zener diode. So for the given regulator circuit, first of all, let us write down all the currents. So let's say IS is the current which is supplied by this voltage source, and IZ and the IL are the currents which are flowing through the Zener diode and the load resistor respectively. So from this we can say that the IS is equal to IZ plus IL. Now for the given regulator circuit, as this voltage source and this series resistor are fixed, so this current IS will remain fixed. And in this circuit, as we reduce the value of RL, then the load current IL will increase. But at the same time, the current which is flowing through the Zener diode will reduce. But to operate the Zener diode as a voltage regulator, the minimum current which should flow through the Zener diode should be at least equal to 10 mA. So from this we can say that for the fixed value of IS, the maximum value of the load current should be such that the current which is flowing through the Zener diode is at least equal to Zener knee current. And from the maximum value of this load current, we will find the minimum value of this load resistor. So first of all, let us find out the value of this source current. So the source current IS can be given as VS minus VZ divided by R, and here it can be written as 10 minus 5 volt divided by 100 ohm, which is equal to 50 milliampere. Now here we have been given that the value of IZK is equal to 10 milliampere. So from this we can say that the maximum value of the load current is equal to IS minus IZK. That means 50 minus 10 milliampere. So the maximum value of the load current is equal to 40 milliampere. And from this we can say that the minimum value of the load resistor will be equal to VZ divided by IL max. That means 5 volt divided by 40 milliampere. So the minimum value of the load resistor will be equal to 125 ohm. So for this circuit to work properly as a voltage regulator, the value of the load resistor should be more than 125 ohm. Now apart from that, we have been also asked to find the minimum power rating of this Zener diode. Now we know that the power rating of the Zener diode, or the power of the Zener diode, can be given as VZ times IZ, where VZ is the voltage across the Zener diode and IZ is the current which is flowing through this Zener diode. Now for any regulator circuit, the power rating of the Zener diode should be such that it should be able to handle the worst case scenario. Now in the given circuit, as we increase the value of RL, then the load current IL will reduce, and at the same time, the Zener current will increase. Now in the worst case, let's say this RL is equal to infinite, or in the no load condition, the entire current IS will flow through this Zener diode. So in the worst case, or in a no load condition, we can say that this IS is equal to IZ. And here we have already found the value of IS, which is equal to 50 milliampere. So we can say that in the worst case condition, the power which is getting dissipated across this Zener diode is equal to 5 volt times 50 milliampere. That is equal to 250 milliwatt. So the minimum power rating of the Zener diode should be equal to 250 milliwatt. So for the given example, the minimum value of the load resistor should be 125 ohm and the minimum power rating of the Zener diode should be equal to 250 milliwatt. Alright, so now let's move to the next example. So in this example, we have been given this Zener diode circuit, and in this circuit, the Zener voltage is equal to 7 volt. And the knee current of the Zener diode is almost negligible. But here we have been given that the Zener resistance of the Zener diode is equal to 10 ohm. So this circuit is operated in the input voltage range from 10 volt to 16 volt. And here we have been asked to find the output voltage range. And here we have been also given the four options. So let us find out which option is correct. So if you observe this circuit, in this circuit, the Zener diode is operated in the no load condition. And in the no load condition, when the input voltage is more than VZ, then the Zener diode will work in the breakdown region. Because if you observe over here, the input voltage range is from 10 volt to 16 volt, which is more than this Zener voltage. So this Zener diode will always operate in the breakdown region. And due to that, we can replace this Zener diode by its equivalent circuit. So in the breakdown region, the Zener voltage is equal to 7 volt and the Zener resistance of the Zener diode is 10 ohm. So considering this, now let us find out the output voltage whenever the input voltage varies from 10 volt to the 16 volt. So here, the expression of the output voltage will be equal to 7 volt plus 10 ohm times this current IS, where the IS is the source current which is supplied by this voltage source. And here, whenever the input voltage is equal to 10 volt, then let's say the source current is equal to IS1. And similarly, whenever the input voltage is 16 volt, then let's say the source current is equal to IS2. So by finding these two values, we will find the output voltage range whenever the input voltage varies from 10 volt to the 16 volt. So first of all, let us consider whenever the input voltage is equal to 10 volt. So for this voltage, let's say the source current is equal to IS1. And the source current IS1 can be written as 10 volt minus 7 volt divided by 200 plus 10 ohm. That is equal to 3 divided by 210 ampere. So from this we can say that the output voltage Vout or VO1 will be equal to 7 volt plus 10 ohm times 3 divided by 210. And if you calculate the value, then the VO1 will come out as 7.14 volt. Similarly, now let us find out the output voltage whenever the input voltage is equal to 16 volt. So considering this Vin as 16 volt, let us find out the source current, and let's say that is equal to IS2. So this source current IS2 can be written as 16 volt minus 7 volt divided by 200 plus 10 ohm. That is equal to 9 divided by 210 ampere. And from this, the output voltage VO2 can be written as 7 volt plus 10 ohm times 9 divided by 210 ampere. And if you calculate the value, then this VO2 will come out as 7.43 volt. So from this we can say that for the given input voltage range, the output voltage varies from 7.14 volt to the 7.43 volt. That means for the given example, the option C is the correct option. Alright, so now let's move to the next example. Now in this example, we have been given this Zener regulator circuit, and in this circuit, the Zener voltage of the Zener diode is equal to 5.8 volt. And apart from that, we have been also given that the Zener knee current is equal to 0.5 milliampere. Now in this circuit, whenever we connect the load across these two terminals, then we have been asked to find the maximum value of the load current such that this circuit will work properly as a voltage regulator, and it should work properly for the input voltage range starting from 20 volt to the 30 volt. So first of all, let us say some load is connected to this regulator circuit. And in this circuit, let's say IS is the source current and IZ and IL are the Zener current and the load current respectively. So here, from applying the KCL at this node, we can write IS is equal to IZ plus IL. Now in this circuit, once the input voltage is fixed, then as we reduce the value of this load resistor, then the current which is flowing through the load will increase, but at the same time this Zener current will reduce. So as we keep on reducing the value of this load resistor, the Zener current which is flowing through the Zener diode will reduce. But we know that for the Zener diode to work properly in the breakdown region, the minimum current it requires is equal to Zener Knee Current. So from this we can say that for the fixed value of the supply current, the maximum value of the load current should be such that at least Zener Knee Current is flowing through this Zener diode. Now here we already know the value of this Zener Knee Current. So to find the maximum value of this load current, first of all we need to find the value of this source current. Now here the input voltage is changing from 20 volt to the 30 volt. So to find the maximum value of the load current, we will consider two extreme points. That means first of all we will find the value of this source current at 20 volt, and then we will find the value of the source current at 30 volt. And from that we will decide what should be the maximum value of the load current. But logically if you see, if we find the value of the load current at minimum input voltage, then the same load current will work properly at the 30 volt. Because at the 30 volt, as the source current will be more, so the remaining current will flow through the Zener diode. So first of all, let us find out this value so that this point will get clear to you. So first of all, let us find out the source current at 20 volt. So we can say that the IS1 is equal to 20 minus 5.8 divided by 1 kilo ohm. That is equal to 14.2 milliampere. And from this, we can say that the maximum value of the load current, that is IL1 max, is equal to 14.2 milliampere minus 0.5 milliampere, that is equal to 13.7 milliampere. Similarly, now let us find out the value of the supply current at 30 volt. So this current IS2 can be given as 30 minus 5.8 divided by 1 kilo ohm, that is equal to 24.2 milliampere. And from this we can say that the maximum value of the load current, that is IL2 max, will be equal to 24.2 milliampere minus 0.5 milliampere, that is equal to 23.7 milliampere. Now here, if we select this value as a maximum load current, then at input voltage of 20 volt, the circuit will not work, because at the 20 volt, the supply current itself is equal to 14.2 milliampere. But instead of that, if we select the value of the maximum load current as 13.7 milliampere, then the circuit will work properly even at a 30 volt, because at that time the supply current is equal to 24.2 milliampere. So at that time the remaining current will flow through this Zener diode. And as this current is more than Zener Knee Current, so the circuit will work properly as a voltage regulator. So from this we can say that the maximum value of the load current should be equal to 13.7 milliampere. Alright, so now let's move to the next example. So in this example, we have been given this Zener regulator circuit, and this circuit is designed to meet the following specifications. That means the load current is equal to 10 milliampere and the output voltage across the load is equal to 10 volt. And here the input voltage Vin is varying from 30 volt to the 50 volt. So here we have been asked to find the value of R such that the circuit will work properly as a voltage regulator. And here we have been also given the specifications for this Zener diode. That means here the VZ is equal to 10 volt and the knee current for the Zener diode is equal to 1 milliampere. So first of all, let us write down what has been given to us. So here the input voltage is varying from 30 volt to the 50 volt. Apart from that, here the output voltage Vout is equal to 10 volt and the load current IL is equal to 10 milliampere. And the Zener knee current for the Zener diode is equal to 1 milliampere. So here, let's say IS is the source current which is supplied by this voltage source. And from this we can say that this current IS is equal to IZ plus IL. So in this circuit, the load current IL is fixed. So for the fixed value of load current, as we increase the value of this R, the supply current or the source current IS will reduce. And due to that, this Zener current IZ will reduce. But we know that the minimum Zener current which is required through the Zener diode should be at least equal to IZK. So from this, we can say that the minimum value of this source current should be such that for the fixed value of the load current, the Zener knee current is at least flowing through this Zener diode. And here, we know that the load current IL is equal to 10 milliampere and the Zener knee current is equal to 1 milliampere. So we can say that for the given circuit, the minimum value of this source current should be equal to 11 milliampere. So here, this source current IS can be given as Vin minus Vz divided by R. So here, the input voltage is varying from 30 volt to the 50 volt. So we will find the minimum value of this IS at 30 volt because that value of R will also work at a 50 volt. Because with that value of R at 50 volt, the value of IS will be more than 11 milliampere. And at that voltage, the circuit will work properly as a Zener regulator. So here, let's find out the minimum value of this source current at a 30 volt. That means 30 minus 10 volt divided by R. So from this, we can say that the value of R should be equal to 20 volt divided by 11 milliampere. And if you calculate this value, then this value will roughly come around as 18 ohm. So this value of R will be the maximum value of this series resistor. So we can say that the value of R should be less than or equal to 18 ohm. So for the given options, the option A is the correct answer. So these are the few examples based on this Zener regulator circuit. And I hope these examples would help you in solving the different examples based on this Zener regulator circuit. So if you have any question or suggestion, do let me know here in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.